Hello everyone, welcome to Developers Checkpoint, and in today's video we are going to learn about the read uncommitted isolation level in the databases. Okay, so what we are going to cover today, we are going to see the scenarios where the read committed and the repeatable read isolation level fail. We will see the example where the read committed isolation level fail using MySQL. After that we are going to discuss the concept of the read uncommitted isolation level. And finally, we are going to see an example of read uncommitted isolation level using MySQL. Okay, so without any further ado, let's dive into the video. So suppose you are into the business of booking seats and you are having a very basic booking schema where you are having a seat and the customer ID. And this customer ID is going to be unique. The table is going to look something like this. So we are having a seat ID and we are having a customer ID, and this customer ID is unique, so we are not allowing any customers to book more than one seat. Okay, and what is the algorithm that we are going to use here? So before creating a booking, we are going to check whether the particular seat is available or not, and if the particular seat is available, we will go ahead and do the booking. Okay, so let's have a scenario where the read committed isolation level is going to fail. So we are having these seats booked by these customer IDs, and suppose a customer is trying to book a seat number 4. Okay, so there are two clients here. One is this client and the other client is this. So what is going to happen in the flow of the user journey is something like this. We are going to check whether the seat ID is available or not. If the seat ID is available, then we are going to request user for doing the payment, and once the payment is done, we are going to initiate a transaction. In that transaction, we are going to check the availability again, whether the seat ID 4 is available or not. And once we found whether the seat is available, we are going to create a booking for the seat number 4. Okay, now assume a scenario where this client is undergoing a transaction and the other client is checking the availability of the seat here. So if this client is going to check the seat availability at this point, the seat 4 is available and the user will be moved ahead to the payment flow. We will ask the user to make the payment, and once the payment is successfully done, we will check the availability again. We will see that the seat is not available, the seat is already booked, and we will not go ahead to create the booking. So in this case, the user is not going to have a pleasant experience that he has done the payment but his booking is not created. Okay, so this is the issue with the read committed isolation level in this scenario, where you are going to book a particular seat or reserve a particular seat for a user. Now let's assume a scenario where we are going to use the repeatable reads here. Okay, so we are having the same configuration here. We have seat 1, 2, 3 booked, and we are trying to book for the seat ID 4. So there are two clients here, and both of them are trying to create a booking. So the user journey will be something like that. The user will check whether the seat is available or not. So the user will find the seat 4 is available. So he will move ahead and proceed to the payment. Once the payment is done, we will initiate the transaction. We are going to check for the availability, and after that, we are going to create the booking for the seat. Okay, now what will happen in case of the other client? So suppose when this transaction was at this point, the transaction was initiated but was not committed. This user is going to check the availability of the seat. He will be able to see the seat is available. He will move ahead to do the payment, and once the payment is done, he is again going to check for the availability. He will be able to see the seat is available, but as this client is going to create the booking, this transaction is going to fail because it was going to violate the constraint of the database. Here we can see we cannot use the repeatable read in this scenario as well. So I am on my terminal. I am running MySQL inside a Docker container. I will add the link to the video in the description where you can find how to run MySQL using a Docker. Okay, so I am having this Docker container running MySQL. So firstly, what I'm going to do, I'm going to search into my Docker container. I'm going to do the same from the other terminal. I'm using two terminals to simulate some kind of concurrency here. Okay, so I'm inside my Docker container and I am going to run the MySQL client. I am going to do the same on the other terminal as well. I am going to create a database named as trans. To create database trans, I'm going to use the trans database, and I'm going to use the same database here. Okay, and now I'm going to create a table named booking. So create table bookings. where the keys are seat ID and the customer ID. And after that, I will make some inserts into the booking table. So this is first entry, and this is going to be the other entry. Now have a look at the bookings table. Select star from bookings. Okay, so this is our table here. So this seat ID 2 is booked by customer ID 1, and this seat ID 1 is booked by customer ID 2. Okay, so firstly, let's set the transaction isolation level to read committed. So I am setting the transaction level on this client as read committed, and the transaction level of read committed to the other client as well. What I am going to do here, firstly, I am going to start a transaction, start transaction. Okay, so suppose I am going to book a seat number 4. So firstly, I will check whether there is entry corresponding to seat number 4 or not. So select asterisk from booking where seat ID equal to 4. So I am not able to see any booking corresponding to seat ID 4. So I am going to insert a booking for the seat ID 4 corresponding to customer 5. Okay, now let's move to the terminal and now start a transaction. Now what I am going to do, I am going to check whether the seat ID 4 is available or not. So I am going to do select asterisk from booking where seat ID is equal to 4, and I am not getting any result here, so which means seat ID 4 is available. So I am going to insert into the booking table with the seat ID as 4 and the customer ID as 6. Okay, now I am going to commit this transaction. I am going to commit this transaction as well. Now let's have a look at the booking table. So I am going to run select asterisk from bookings. What we can see here, that the seat ID 4 is booked for 2 customers. So this is the inconsistency here. We checked the availability of seat ID 4, but we were not able to see the booking for the customer ID 5 while this transaction was running. This is the issue with the read committed isolation level. Now let's have a look at how the read uncommitted isolation level solves this problem. So this scenario brings the use case of a read uncommitted isolation level. So what is going to happen in case of read uncommitted isolation level is something like that. So suppose the initial value of x was 1, and there was a user who was starting a transaction and was trying to set the value of x equal to 2. Transaction was started at this point. The value of x equal to 2 was set at this point, but the transaction is still not committed. So if the other client comes and tries to read the value of x, it will be able to read the value of x equal to 2. So the value of x that was set by a transaction, the transaction was still not committed, but this client was able to see the uncommitted value of the transaction. So this is the scenario of read uncommitted isolation level. So now let's have a look at how read uncommitted isolation level is going to solve this problem. Okay, so we are having the two clients, both are trying to book a seat. So the first client is going to check the availability of the seat ID 4. If found the seat available, he will move ahead to do the payment. And once the payment is successfully done, the user is going to initiate the transaction and will go ahead and book the seat. So if any client tries to read the availability of this seat ID 4, once the transaction is in progress and this booking has been done, he will be able to see that the seat is not available. So someone is either trying to book the seat or has already booked the seat. So in this flow, we are not going to move ahead and move to the payment flow. So we have saved the user from the pathetic journey. So this is the important use case of the read uncommitted isolation level. So what I am going to do now, I am going to start a transaction. So start transaction. I am going to check the availability of seat ID 5. So select asterisk from booking where seat ID is equal to 5. Seat ID 5 is available. So I'm going to book this seat for the customer numbers 8. So seat ID is 5 and customer ID is 8. Okay. And now start a transaction on the other terminal. Going to check the availability of seat ID 5 here. And this transaction is still not committed, and I can see that the seat ID is booked for the customer ID 8. Okay, so now as we have seen that the seat ID is booked, so we will not move ahead to create the booking for this customer. Okay, so this is the use case of the read uncommitted isolation level. So guys, that's for the video. Please like and share the video if you like the content, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.